language is yours? German and French. Oh,
yeah. So it's
more than switching languages.
Yeah.
I barely know English.
Well, you speak American.
Huh?
Well, I've been a teacher for a couple of years, and specifically I used to teach at the summer school in at the London School of Economics. And we had students coming in from all over the world who were eager to have that kind of education. However, they had to spend quite a lot of money, and I thought that the education that they were receiving was a real opportunity for them. It was just a pity that it couldn't reach more people. So I started playing around with the idea of making it available to people who couldn't afford it, and then eventually discussed this with a couple of people, and Magix specifically said, well, let's try this in Sierra Leone. Yes, that's exactly what we decided to do. Tessie joined immediately and was instrumental in getting it off the ground. And we were only really able to create this because we started in Sierra Leone where Magix already had ties where we could test our model and see if it would work, if something from the London School of Economics could be exported abroad. And our first year, our pilot year, was a success, so we decided to expand it.
What do you hope that your organization can achieve?
In my wildest dreams?
Yes.
I would love to see Professors Without Borders become like Doctors Without Borders, be the main resource for academic mobility, for professors to travel around the world, to be able to share their passion for teaching, their knowledge, and inspire students to want to pursue knowledge, to want to put their ideas into practice. And I think if we can reach this on a massive scale and inspire the future, I don't want to even say leaders, because just the future of the world, then we will have more than achieved our goal.
What have you learned throughout this process?
That it is incredibly exciting to be working on your own project with people that you like. Very empowering to put your ideas into practice and to test and see if they are validated. And very rewarding to be working with so many volunteers who have supported us and who have contributed their ideas and their talent to the organization.
What's the biggest challenge that you faced?
Money. That's, I think, the problem with most startups. It's getting the funding so that we don't pay out of pocket, to send the best professors and to fund their trip and all of their needs on the ground. However, we've had very generous benefactors who have believed in our idea, but we need to make this sustainable to be able to enjoy in the long term.
What's been your favorite part?
My favorite part? Certainly not the logistics. I think working with the volunteers and working with Magix and Tessie, my favorite part has been the people's game, getting to know everybody on a professional dimension and seeing how far we can go together.
Great. Thanks so much.
What was the favorite part of the others?